Hi, and welcome to Stephen Helwig Talks Tech. Today I'm going to show you how to deploy a WordPress website on Azure using Azure App Service and Azure Database for MySQL. WordPress is one of the most popular content management systems and blogging platforms that exist on the market today, and it's used by individuals as well as governments and large enterprises to maintain their web presence. So I'll dig into how to deploy each component, how to connect them together, and how to configure your WordPress website. If you're new here to Stephen Helwig Talks Tech, we appreciate every like and subscribe. We also love to hear from you, so please put your comments below. Let me know what you liked about the video. If there are other things that you want me to cover, whether it's Azure or otherwise, please let me know in the comment section below. And as always, please hit that subscribe button, hit that bell if you want to get notified when I have new content. Okay, let's get started. We're going to get started by firstly configuring the Azure database for MySQL and get it configured in a way that we can connect our WordPress website to it. So let's dig into the portal. So I'm here in a subscription. There's nothing in the subscription. The first thing I'm going to do is create a resource group. You can create your resource group during the creation of the blog or the database, but I'm just going to create one here in advance, and I'm going to leave it in East US. I use the rg-prefix for most of my resource groups. We'll create that very quickly. See, it's already done, so we'll go to that resource, and let's create some resources. Go in here and search for MySQL. And you see here, it says Azure Database for MySQL. This is the PaaS version of MySQL. You can see there are a lot of other options here in the marketplace, but we're gonna be using this one. And Microsoft has really gone out of their way to create a lot of different PaaS versions of the database, right? So it's it used to be that Azure Database was just SQL Server, but now there's a MySQL flavor, there's a Postgres flavor, there's a MariaDB flavor, and that doesn't even encompass the NoSQL options like Cosmos DB. So we're going to create the Azure database for MySQL. We'll click create here. And we're going to use this new flexible server preview. It allows us for some lower cost options. So we're going to go with that one. When we get in here, it's going to ask us for a few things. Server name, what region we're located in, what's the workload type. You see here there's production, small, medium size, production, large size, and then development. We're going to do development, and that'll allow us the lowest cost option for doing the server. For the server name, I'm just going to put in MySQL Server WP-SH, which is my initials, and then we'll just click into here to compute and storage and just take a look at the cost. So you see the tiers that we have here. We have a burstable tier, which is 1 to 2 cores, and it's best for workloads that don't need full CPU continuously. And this is a small WordPress website, so that should be more than good enough. And then there are other tiers as well, and you can click choose even larger VM sizes here. So I'm actually gonna go down to this 1 vCore and 1 gig of memory. And you see that only costs me $13.80 a month, okay? So we'll use that for now, and I can always go in and scale it up later on if I need to. And we'll choose locally redundant storage and a retention period of 7 days. Availability zones, we don't need availability zones for what we're doing. And for the MySQL version, we're gonna go with 8.0.2.R21. We'll put in some username information here. Next, we'll go over to networking. For now, we're going to use public access. The great thing about this database is you can integrate it with the VNet, and we can do some private networking, but we're not going to spend time doing that now. So for right now, we'll just use public access, and I'm going to click allow public access from Azure services, from any Azure service within Azure to the server, and that will allow my web app to access it later on. And I'm gonna add my current IP address as well, so that way I can access the database from my local PC. We'll then go to review and create, and we'll click create. Okay, so our deployment's kicked off. Let's give it a second to create the database. Okay, now that the resource is created, let's go to it and get some useful information that we need in order to set up our database. So you can see some information about the database here that's been created. See some information on this side, such as the configuration tier, the connectivity method, the server name, and login. So we're gonna just grab that server name and we'll store that off to the side. And we'll also go into the connection string and we will grab the connection string. Okay, so I'm gonna copy the ADO.NET connection string to my clipboard. Now we're gonna pop over to Heidi SQL. I've put a link if you wanna download Heidi SQL in the description below. So that's the program that I'm gonna be using on my desktop to connect to the database and get it set up. So I've opened Heidi SQL. I've pasted in my host name information that I just copied out, my username and password. I'm using port 3306, which is the standard port for my SQL. And then I'm also gonna go to this advanced tab here and select use SSL. Okay, then I'm gonna select open. And it says settings for blog were changed. I'll say yes. And now I am connected into my database. So from here, I'm gonna create a new database that I'm going to call WordPress. So I'll right click on the connection and I'm gonna say create new database. I'll title this WordPress. Here, and you can see it's actually writing the SQL script down here. And then for the connection, or sorry, the collation, I'm going to use UTF-8 MB4 Unicode underscore CI. I'm going to select OK, and the database is created. So you can see there's nothing in this database right now, but we have a database created. And that's all we really need to do. We don't need to create any tables or anything. When WordPress connects to the database for the first time, it will configure all of the necessary tables for it to work. So that's it. We have the Postgres database configured. We have it connected. We've connected to it from Heidi SQL on our desktop. We've created the database. The server is up and running. So now we can go over and create the app service and pull in the WordPress container and then get that connected to the database. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create an Azure app service and we're going to create a Linux-based app service that pulls over the WordPress Docker container. So let's go into the portal and do that next. Okay, we're back into our resource group here and you can see our WordPress database or our MySQL database has been created. And so I'm gonna go back up here and say add from the marketplace and we're just gonna select this web app option. You can also type web app here in the search bar if you don't see this come up. So I'm gonna select web app and I'm gonna give it a name and we'll call it Stephen Helwig Talks Tech WP. And for the runtime stack, we're going to select, we're going to go with Docker container and we're going to select Linux. Okay, so we've selected Docker container Linux. We want to put this in the same region that we put our database in. So we'll select East US and you'll see it's automatically selected this WordPress resource group. And then we're going to change the size. We don't need, you know, premium tier here. We're going to go down to dev test and we'll select B1. Actually, we'll go with a standard tier in this case. Let's go with an S1 here, okay? And next we're gonna go to Docker. And you can select this quick start container, but I'm gonna instead go to the Docker Hub registry, which is a public registry, and I wanna grab the WordPress image, okay? And I'm not gonna put in a startup command here, I'm just gonna leave it as is. Okay, so we'll go review and create, and we will click create. It's initializing and submitting deployment. So we'll come back once this has been created. Okay, our web app was deployed. So we will go to that resource. And you can see it's up and running here. This is the Azure web app. An Azure web app also has an app service plan. And so when we chose the size earlier, we were really choosing the app service plan size. And you can see it's a Linux-based app service plan. And what's great about an app service plan is that you can deploy multiple apps onto this app service plan. So I could host 10 or 15 WordPress sites on this single app service plan. You're just utilizing all of the capacity that's available to you on the app service plan. So I'm gonna go back into the one web app we've deployed here. And there are some configuration options that we need to set. So I'm going to go into the configuration setting and I'm gonna copy and paste in some configuration options that will allow me to connect to the database. So the first setting is the connection string to the database or the host name. So we're gonna use WordPress DB host. And the value is going to be the connection string or the host name that we used earlier. Okay, we'll click OK with that one. The next one is going to be the user that we use to connect to the database. And then we will paste in the password. And lastly, we are going to paste in a value for some flags, or some extra config values rather. So for a client flag to use SSL, we're just going to grab and put that in there. Okay, make sure there's nothing here at the beginning. All right, so those are the initial configuration values we need to set. So then we will hit save. Now that we've added the configuration values, we can go back to the overview pane and we can click the URL to open up the website. And from there, it should take us through the WordPress configuration process. So it'll take a couple seconds to initially load, but you can see here it's brought up the loading screen for WordPress. And this is the standard configuration process you'd go through for any WordPress blog. So we're gonna give it a site title, YouTube test here. We can set a username and a random password. I'll just copy that off, right? And we'll set an email address. And from there, we can install WordPress. Now we'll go through the process of installing WordPress and connecting and talking to the database. So if we were to open up Heidi SQL here and we were to maybe refresh this, you'd see that now the WordPress tables have been installed, right? So these are the standard WordPress tables. It's done that work for us. So while it's installing, it'll add the information necessary to these tables. Okay, so now it's ready, success. So we can log into our WordPress blog here. So I'll go ahead and use the username and password we just set and click login. And there we are. We can start customizing our website and writing our first blog or setting up our first pages. It's a standard WordPress website now running on Azure. You can see here in the bar, it's using that azurewebsites.net and it's connecting to the backend database. I hope you enjoyed that quick look at how you can set up a WordPress website on Azure using our Azure Database for MySQL and Azure App Services. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. I love to hear from you all. If you have any suggestions for future videos, please leave them in the comments as well. As always, we appreciate every like and subscribe. If you have yet to subscribe to the channel, please hit the subscribe button now. Hit the notification bell if you want to get notified of new videos. All right, thanks. Bye.